Y'all, I got a family to feed, so let's get into this tea. Drama alert, I am Zoe vs. Karma 2.0. Cardi B and Offset breakup. Did he cheat with Krishan? Let's get it.
It is so much going on, but I ain't got nothing to do with it.
It's a whole lot of going on. It's a whole lot of going on. It's a whole lot of going on. It's a whole lot of going on.
It's Monday, and you know what that means. If it ain't about me, then I'm a Kiki. First on the docket, and I'ma talk shit. Got my sugar, honey, iced tea. Do you want to sell now, period? I said what I said. Now move along, bitch, before you get red. P.O.P., you can't stick with me. Come on, girls, let's get
a whole lot going on.
Hey creeps, and welcome back to Messy Monday. As you already know, you can't sit with me unless you are POP, and that is pretty on purpose.
How you doing?
Okay, so first of all, can we just say how is a whole lot going on? Y'all can argue for 7 and 12 and 15 days, but bitch, I ain't gonna talk about all them days. Bitch, you got me. Anyway, so before we start, I must say congratulations to y'all. We are in the middle. Is it the middle? Kind of middle? Whatever. We're almost done with December. And you guys have made it another week. I ain't seen you in two, so y'all made it 2 weeks. Shouts out to y'all, because like I always say, it is real messy out here in these streets. And baby, it be a whole lot going on. For you to keep your sanity, shouts out
okay.
to you. Now, I'm going to give a shout out to my friend, and that is Max.
Hey, bitch.
Max, child, thank you so much for having my post notifications on. I greatly appreciate that. You were the first to comment on my Twitter post, and that lets me know that you want to know what the hell I got to say, baby. And I fucked with that, okay? So, keep on doing you. Y'all go over there and follow her, show her some love. She's a part of the Zoe Navy, and we are one. So, I'm going to always ride with you, friend.
Hey, bitch.
All right. Let's go on and get my little book. We finna go on and get into this. Let's go on and get into the shit. The sugar, honey, iced tea. Because you girls
love staying in some shit.
First, the sugar, honey, iced tea, we have me and Carmen. Baby, y'all didn't even have to tell me this. We already knew that it was gonna come to something like this. And then, let's just be clear. Sometimes it can be the fans that will start to pull and tear people apart. Because it may not even...
Did they fall out again?
...be anything. But the fact that y'all are saying stuff and making it look like what you think it is, then it could cause some feud between these two women. As y'all already know, the girls had stopped talking a long time ago because allegedly it was some stuff that went down. I guess she supposedly had fucked with King, whatever the case may be, whoop, 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 yada, yada, yada. The friendship had tore apart. So child, Meek went her separate way, Corn went her separate way. Now they have found their ways back to each other after they both left them old men. Corn and Shane with Corey no more. So she's been dibbling and dabbling all over lollygagging and everybody videos. I don't know why she don't do her own video, but now she in these girls' video. Are they girls together?
She in everybody video to get that coin. Because your friend took all her damn money. Well, not all her money, but he took at least a point. Hey, that nigga could have gave her some money before he got up out of there. For real. That's just trifling. But anyway.
Yeah, but this is a girl-girl thing. I don't fucking know. People are saying they feel Meek be shading Carmen.
Now, people have called Meek out because they stated in her recent video with Carmen, they're stating the energy was off and Meek wasn't feeling Carmen.
Which had Meek come out and then this is what she say about everybody saying she's shading the girl.
Why do you seem like you don't really like Carmen for real? The video seemed like you just acting nice. Y'all kept commenting that the last time we did like two videos from now or two videos before this video, y'all was trying to say when we did the TMI Girls Talk video, y'all was trying to say that I was being mean to Carmen or I was looking at her a certain way or I was acting a weird way towards her. Y'all, we had did like three videos before that video one. Maybe I was exhausted from talking.
Okay.
I wasn't even like.
It's possible.
Stop taking stuff so personal. Like literally, I wasn't acting those way towards her. Yeah, I said that Y'all take that whole, it doesn't sit right with me that Neek still believes this, that, and the third. It's my feelings. Like, I feel that way. And I could forgive somebody, or I could be in the same room with somebody, or I could talk to a person, I could befriend a person again and still stand on how I felt.
And to be honest, it's all messy to me anyway. Because I don't know why Carmen want to hang with me. Because if this girl is telling you that she still feels as though that you messed with her boyfriend and you're telling her I did not.
Oh, hell no. No, 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 no. That damn Carmen. Carmen, sis, get your coin and get the hell on. Because if Neek still believed that and you saying that you didn't do that and that her mind is made up, that means one night y'all gonna fuck around and get drunk and somebody gonna joke about it and you gonna get your ass beat again by Neek, friend. Run while you can. Run, okay? Let me tell y'all something. When somebody still believe it's some Anna when it ain't none, first of all, that whole situation shouldn't have never happened. I hate that it happened. I don't think that they did anything, though. I'm not going to lie. I really don't think that they did anything. But when somebody still feel a certain way, it comes out when that tequila, that casa frico get to hitting. Then they get to hitting. You get what I'm saying? Run, Carmen.
Girl. But I don't know. I'm all here for them trying to rekindle things and fix a friendship.
Don't get your
that
ass
once
beat.
Was.
Run.
But I just feel like once you betray somebody, your friendship will never be the same. And the reason I say that is because, like Neek said, she forgave her, but she still feels the way she feels. Mm-hmm. And I feel like when you forgive somebody, you let everything go.
You do.
You know, if she says she didn't miss the person, she didn't miss the person. You let it go, you forgive, and it's all gone. Because now I feel like there's still this little wall of untrust there.
It
makes any sense. But hey, we're going to see how this goes. I wish them the best. And keep making your videos. If it ain't about me, does Neek really like Little Miss Carmine? Next case. Next for Shagunny Ice Tea, we have 2.0 versus Zoe. Now, as everybody know, Corey has moved on and so has Carmen.
And love you being Carmen's friend. Congratulations. I'm definitely not Carmen's friend.
Damn.
The word friend sounds, you know, a little too vague. I don't know why y'all keep talking about past shit. Listen, stop talking about past shit with me. That's just, it's not irritating. I get it, but damn. Like, let me make my own destiny with somebody.
Yeah, that's irritating.
If that is somebody that I will ever be with.
Now, I don't know what Carmen sees in Michi, but it's not for me or any of us to know what she sees. It's whatever she likes. I just think Carmen can do better. Is it fine? Yes, he fine. But I just feel Carmen could do better because we've seen Michi and his, you know, track record. Not just say because...
Yo, all these niggas is hoes, bro. Every last one of these men are hoes. I don't think none of y'all should take any of them serious. Got to get some earrings. I don't think none of y'all should take any of them serious. And then everybody in their 20s, everybody out here making all this money. I don't be understanding the whole, well, okay, let me stop saying that because I do understand. Everybody want that in-house. They want that in-house but want to act like that out though, okay? Bruh, all of them are hoes. Quit wasting y'all damn time and go have y'all some fun. Shit.
That's the only thing.
The woman is the home. The woman is the home. Y'all don't even be need niggas. Hell, if you want to get something built or something, go to TaskRabbit. You don't need him at all. Like, women is absolutely the home, so... They be fiending for you more than you fiend for them, guaranteed.
But because we seen him when he was hanging out with Shotta Greatest and just, I don't know, it just feels like he places himself in situations to better himself, not because
absolutely.
That's what he wants to be. Just like he racked up with Black China. I'ma leave it alone. Now, on to this thing over here. Corey, everybody know I love
shit.
Me for Corey. I don't know what the mama got going on, but when I was talking to you on that live...
So Corey and his boo thing was live together. Recently, Corey tweet, I wish I met her first. And Zoe tweet that she looked like a Carmen 2.0.
Damn, she
well,
looks just
Zoe
like Carmen.
Recently joined the live with Corey and his boo. Listen.
You could talk so much to you. This is going to talk so much.
Corey.
Oh, but, my God. Corey, are you fucking kidding me?
Corey.
If a doppelganger was a person, yo, what the fuck? Ain't no way. It ain't no way. Oh my God, she is a doppelganger.
Corey, I don't. What's going on? What's going on? I thought you told me they said no pets in the new condo.
Yo, pets is crazy.
No, that first of all, and is that an SSG chain on her neck?
No, actually, that's a chain she bought.
On her ew.
Yeah. Oh, okay. I'm just checking.
With the roll that she bought.
I don't care what she got on her wrist. It, I don't care.
I ain't bought nothing. I ain't
spending dollars. I mean, but she is cute. What's that show that was on? What is it? They was in the carriage and she had a red purse. What's that? You know the little cartoon?
No,
they was in the carriage. She was on a date. She had a red purse. And then I think the boyfriend ended up running.
Yo, you know what I'm talking about? The fact that Corey laughing, that would have pissed me off if I was her.
She, oh, the Muppet babies.
Hey, Zoe.
Zoe is so shady. Oh, my God.
That's what she remind me of.
What, Zoe, why you always
got
to pick people?
I'm going to look that
I'm up. Not picking. What you say, little girl?
Don't ever little me.
What you say, little girl?
I said what I said.
Not girl, Zoe said something wrong with... Zoe talking about, I don't know what was wrong with her. You was cutting her ass. He was cutting ass.
The thing big over there is that mouth. That's what he.
Why is he laughing?
And you.
She said,
girl, I don't know. And then she had them, she had them safety pins going down her head like a diaper. I know you lying. Corey, why you let her just walk around you like that?
What you mean? She got style. She got class.
Nah, all them safety pins and them clips is crazy. Why?
Classless.
So she said, "Is this a girl or a boy?" Because I can't tell.
What's that? Girl, we couldn't tell what you was either, but we accepted you.
Yo, Corey is hell. I would have been so mad if I was her.
Corey, stop. Why is you, Corey? I love you, Corey.
Man, get the fuck on that shit, bro.
Turn me up, Corey. What's that song? Turn me up.
Yo, this nigga, Corey. Hey, hell.
Check at the check. At the check. Corey.
You ain't
tab me or
none of that shit in my music.
Corey, that's my song. I love that song, Corey.
Can you
pull
my song? So you want to be
the instrument. Okay, shut up. Well, just let her know if she's going to be around. I'm not taking my foot off her neck. Goodbye, Corey. I love you.
Is it a he or
a
she?
Zoe is a he, but Zoe is, you know, I don't know what he considers himself.
It's a punk.
Damn, did she say it's a punk?
What'd you ask me to do? What?
It's a punk. It's a punk.
A punk.
Yeah.
A punk. Man, get back, man. Get out of my shit. Get back. Leave that alone.
A punk.
Leave that man alone. Nah, so cool as hell. You know something?
What you not gonna do, Miss Arts and Crafts, is call somebody a punk. Okay, that's what we not gonna do. Because, you know, it was a kiki and a cackle with you. I was playing, baby. But if you want to get in your feelings, sound like a good old drag queen, then you can do that, girl. But don't call me what you look like, okay? A punk. So, let's just leave it at that. You know, I don't want to tuck phone because you are a social experiment, Corey. You're not here for a long time. You're here for a good time, okay? So, enjoy it while you can.
Just wait till I get on live with Corey. I'ma lay y'all ass out.
Girl, why she sound like Carmen too? Ew.
You're not here for a long time. You're here for a good time, okay? So, enjoy it while you can.
Just wait till I get on live with Corey. I'ma lay y'all ass out. Cause a lot of people can't see me right now, like what I gotta say right now. I'm with Corey and the whole world gonna see me. The whole world's gonna fucking know. Cause people don't know that. People be so ignorant.
Girl, shut the hell up. You talking about you don't want no negative energy and you don't want this and this and that. Bitch, you knew what the fuck was coming when you got with Corey. You knew that you looked like that girl.
Right.
You knew that Corey had just got out of a relationship with his wife.
Right.
Bitch, you knew all this. Why can't you just shut the fuck up like Meechie? Meechie ain't saying shit. You don't say shit. Just be with the fuck Corey. And if you don't want to be all in the
girl,
bullshit.
Girl, she's not even a replacement. She's a fill-in. For whoever he gonna end up being with. It ain't gonna be Carmen. But she's a fill-in for the next girl. Because that ain't it. He should be disgusted with himself. I would look at Carmen. That would be Carmen. If he was just so like, I don't want to be with Carmen. Like, you got right back with her. That's crazy.
Hell, you wanna be in the camera every time? Oh, next time I'm in the camera, I'ma let y'all have it. Y'all gonna feel me. Nah, bitch, you gonna feel us. You think you ready for this bullshit? These motherfuckers gonna run you off the neck. Corey better let you know what you up against. Cause these motherfuckers gonna eat your ass alive.
Okay.
She finna come in here and step on shit, but nobody know who the fuck she is, what the fuck she doing, where the fuck Rita. She came from. Bitch, they gonna eat you.
Rita. Carmen is Amazon and sis is Timo. That's what she just said.
You up, Miss Thang. And Corey gonna be so embarrassed to even be around you that he gonna throw your ass back in the streets. Anyway, let me get up off her because she pissed me off. We know a gold digger when we see one. Well, if it ain't about me, let's be here. Next for the Sugar Honey Ice Tea, we got Jay Slutty and Jazz versus R. Now, I don't know if y'all remember, but maybe like a month back, it was a situation going on with DeShay, Ari, and Wuda. Everybody knows DeShay does videos with a lot of female influencers, and so they end up doing one. So she allegedly got drunk, or whatever the case may be. While she got drunk, it was said that DeShay had allegedly, you know, sexually assaulted her. He's saying he didn't. Wuda ended up getting mad at DeShay. It was just a whole lot of big old debacle. So honey, now she done brought in Jay Slutty and said he tried to do the same thing.
Now, ma'am. No. I'm gonna tell y'all what done happened. She done got drunk again off that Casa Frico. And she tired of looking like a Casa Mijo. That's exactly what it is. She out here giving unwarranted coochie when she drunk. And before they end up trying to call her a hoe, she coming out saying that somebody's taking her goodies. Now, it's one thing for one to do it. And then for niggas to be on the same platform, by the way. It's one thing for one of them to do it. I ain't saying it can't happen now. I ain't saying two of them can't do it. But the fact that she was on that Casa Frico, and even DeShay had proof that she went to his room. That nigga told her to go lay down. She went to his room. I don't believe her. But I will say, Jay Slutty is crazy. None of y'all men should be anywhere near that girl. Because she going to have you lined up. What the fuck is wrong with y'all? All these women on these platforms, all this money y'all got, and y'all decide to go with the one that's accusing you of S.A. Come on.
What the fuck is going on? Why are you always in these situations? And why are you always getting so drunk to the point that you black out? If that's the case, you need to stop going and you need to stop drinking. Because I don't know what the fuck going on.
And I didn't expose Jay Slutty because I didn't want to ruin what, you know, Perfect Labs and Loaded and Badass Flow got. Like, I didn't want to, like, put them into any mess. But it's like, now I kind of got to clear my name up because Deshae is saying I put false accusations on people before. And I seen that Deshae was with Perfect Labs in the club or something. So I don't know if she told him. I don't know if Flo, I don't know if Flo told him, because after the situation happened, Flo had called me. I don't know if Flo told him, or I don't know if Jay Slay told him.
So now Jazz did respond to all this on her Twitter. She went on to state, "I have nothing to do with nothing. Leave me out of the BS and drama."
Right.
Well, then Jay Slutty goes on to respond as well.
Absolutely not, Jay Slutty. I'll rather do a video looking crazy as hell than typing books like them. A girl who has been consistently, wait. A girl who has been consistently been, okay, exposing and excusing multiple influencers of mistreating her, mental abuse, and SA, has recently come forward to falsely accuse me of SA, I guess. I want to be clear when I say this to all of my supporters. I did nothing wrong, and I have proof that will show my innocence. I would laugh and giggle sometimes when I would hear about women falsely accusing famous men for their money and fame. And now that it's happening to me, I think about how there really should be a law to arrest women who falsely accuse men for attention, money, and fame. Because it really does hurt the voices of the real victims who are really experiencing this. It's really not fair, because what this girl is doing now is making it harder for women to be taken seriously when this does happen to a lot of them. Now, that's facts. I know she gonna read, but I'd rather read it myself, friend. I want to give a message to my supporters. I have never had and never will have to SA or ever had to do none of that sort. Sort of stuff to have whatever with girls. I'm basically defending myself because I never thought something like this would happen to me. I have a daughter and a sis. What do I look like doing that? Jesus Christ. I'm gonna say this, y'all. Now a lot of these niggas do be tripping. They be doing a lot of dumb shit. But to right after somebody else was accused of it, and then you put her in your bed too, is crazy. I think y'all niggas is stupid as fuck sometimes. That I understand you got two heads and two brains or whatever, but baby, go with the top. Because, bro, I would have never had that girl in my bed. I already know that you that type of chick anyway. I don't need you in my bed. Hell to the no.
Okay, but he said thank you and thanks for understanding. I'm sorry.
Okay.
Has consistently been
I just
want
her to stop nagging at me about this.
All right, bet, I got you. I'm finna do it right now, so just send it right now.
Okay, bet, be safe. Thank you, and thanks for understanding. I'm sorry.
Okay, vice versa.
I don't know why Jay Slade trying to post that conversation. Like, that wasn't after he sent the $500. You sent $500 for the shoes, bruh. Like, why would you send, why would you come up out of $500 and give somebody $500 if you didn't try to, you said,
why would you pay a woman $500 after you did such a ridiculous thing? Like, why would you even just ask for $500? If you did that and I'm trying to blackmail you, I need more than that. I would hope you would need more than
that. That's why you sent me the $500 and you was trying to pay me $2,000. Like, be for real. And I told you no. Why would I dry text you and tell you to send me $2,000? If I was that desperate over some money, don't you think I would have exposed you?
You,
come on now.
That's okay, so if she didn't expose them, how did it happen? How did this get out?
In the same day I met you. So don't try to get up on the internet and try to make it seem like you didn't try to do that shit and you did. If I wanted to expose you, I could have been exposed you. Or if it was for the money, I could have been said something. Like, come on now. I'm only saying something because somebody told Frost that I try to put allegations on somebody before, and I never did.
To me, I was kind of on her side, but now I'm just like, why the fuck is she always blacking out and getting drunk?
I'm not on her side. I'm sorry, y'all. Now, y'all know I am not for the SA. I'm not for the R words. I'm not for the M words. I do not play that when it comes to women, but I will say some women do be fucking lying. Okay? They do. I got brothers. I got cousins. They ain't jacking none of that. And if they ever were to, I'm whooping ass, okay? But with that being said, like, I blame Jay Slutty. I'm not gonna lie. I would have never had no conversation with that girl. And he knew what happened with DeShay. Everybody knew what happened with DeShay. So why would Jay Slutty be opted out of that conversation? He knew. So why the hell would you get anywhere near that girl? No. Get away from me. I think that she's very focused on not being called a hoe. Oh, Nick, it was before the DeShay situation. That makes it even worse. You exposed DeShay before you exposed Jay Slutty? Which means you was going for the big money first, which would be DeShay. So why did he end up coming out saying that after the... Well, how did this come out? How did this come out is what I want to know. But why would you not expose Jay Slutty first? So I get it. Y'all trying to tell me that basically he was, this happened before DeShay, so he wouldn't even been warned about her. I get it. I get it now. So she exposed it. What the fuck? And then trying to bring Jazz and Flo in it. That's crazy. What is she bringing Jazz and Flo in it for? See, this is why. Y'all, everybody want me to react to this YouTube shit, but bro, y'all cannot handle what I say. They can't handle what I say. I ain't got time. But damn, y'all got some, they got some tea going on over there. It's a lot of, it's some shit going on the YouTube side that it sounds like I need to be in. It needs my conversation, okay?
Happened with this guy, happened with the shade, it happened with
I'd rather
this
react on another channel. I'd rather create a whole nother channel for this shit. I ain't gonna lie.
Like, out of drunk,
she said she didn't want to mess up her
dragon
relationship with
and
funny
then on top of that, they need to stop inviting her places since they know she like this. Why the fuck would you want to hang out with her? And she need to stop going places drinking if she know this is what happened.
Yeah, she
why
need to put the Casa Freako down.
Influencer then, if that's the case. I ain't trying to victim blame and blame victim and shame that and this and that, but bitch, somebody gotta wake the fuck up.
Hell right, all y'all men need to get the hell away from her. I'm trying to tell you. If this happened with somebody else, nah, that was just your fault, gang. Unless she say the shit was before too, but that was just your fault. It's given. Hold on. It's given that this shit, that she be waking up from being drunk and then be like, oh shit, what did you do to me? What did you do to me? That's what it's really given, for real.
Next for Sugar Honey Ice, we have Nudie versus Flo. Now, I'm so happy this shit happened. I know that sounds bad to say, but
what happened?
Somebody do something out of spite.
When I tell you I'm out the loop, I'm out the loop.
Then karma gonna come on your door. So I don't know if y'all remember, a couple of months ago, Karina had got into an altercation with Flo.
Mm-hmm.
Allegedly, Flo put his hands on her, mm-hmm, whatever the case may be, woo, woo, woo.
Mm-hmm.
Then that's when Nudie, his ex-girlfriend, came out the cut talking about some, I don't believe it, he ain't never put his hands on me.
Mm-hmm.
That's when Nudie and Karina got into a little 1-2, mm-hmm, and it is what it is. And you know, mm-hmm, Nudie getting mad, that's when she kissing him in the backseat like, yeah, I got your man, yeah, I got your man. Nah, bitch, her man had got you and played you. That nigga just needed somewhere to stay.
Mm-hmm.
That's what he did. He needed somewhere to stay. You fell for it. He used you up and spit you out.
So it appears that Flo and Nudie may have broken up. They unfollowed each other on Instagram, which you guys know is the first sign of a breakup.
And that's what happened. And girl, you look so stupid believing this man, after this man is known for disrespecting these women. Mind you, they were supposed to be going to the Bad Kids prom the other day together because they was confirmed, but didn't show up. But guess who still went anyway by himself? He did. Flo went by himself with the friends and still had fun, didn't give a fuck about her. And when they unfollow each other on Instagram, she goes and she say this right here. I gotta stop letting people show me 4 or 5 times when they done already showed me once.
Hello.
Bitch, you knew that. You knew that, but you was just so old, ready to pop out and go be Mrs. Save-A-Hole, and now, bitch, you just done got played like a hoe. It's just stupid. That man just put his hand on a woman, and you thinking,
T-Room don't miss a damn thing, you hear me?
Make you different. Then while he out partying the thing, she go, I guess she think it's gonna make him mad. I wanna be ducked off solo with somebody tonight. We don't give a fuck.
Okay.
Go do it. Text somebody. Call them. FaceTimer, but bitch, we do not care.
This dating for 20-year-olds got to be one of the worst hobbies in life right now. And then y'all remember, when we was 20-something, we wasn't fucking rich. So these 20-year-olds out here rich as hell. And I'm going to say another thing, a quick little 30-year-old message. Don't be out here feeling bad that these 20-year-olds is rich and y'all ain't rich yet. Y'all better learn from these little motherfuckers and work on them riches. But anyway, I just had to bring some of y'all in because a lot of y'all, a lot of 30-year-olds are jealous of these 20-year-olds because they rich. Don't be jealous. They going through hell right now. They might be able to buy what they want, but goddamn, at least we got some sanity. Okay, but anyway, I would not want to be 20 right now, rich and lonely and dating. They going through it. Now, these men probably out here smashing everything, walking, but it get a little different for the girls. You know what I'm saying? They going through it. I will say I'm actually happy I didn't come up in their generation of 20s. I get it. They get a lot of money. Cool. But baby, I sleep great at night. And don't get me wrong, I'm getting a lot of money now as well. However, I'm just saying. Before I was getting the money, you know, when I was big back and broke, like Armand say, I was cool. I was cool with the big back and broke. I'm trying to dig.
Don't want to be in no mix. obviously, we know that. You're at home, sweetie. And you're not with that.
Sweetie.
How can you be in a mix if you're not invited? Now who got him? Not you.
Hey, not hell. Yet.
Now she got beat up, pop, slap, egg.
Absolutely. If you have two public relationships, you are a pass around. Hello.
But that's just none of our business, child, Karina. And then y'all can't change that man. That's who that man is.
Yeah, facts.
You was just a rebounding girl. Your time is up. If it ain't
Karina about was me, trying to tell her.
Let's keep eating. Next case. Next to the Sugar Honey Iced Tea, we have Quan Rondo. Well, it looks like the love bird finally called it quits. He has really been going hard for this.
Can we skip this? Because I don't give a goddamn. Okay, so it didn't look like this lasted long anyway. Oh, it didn't.
Girl, but now I think he's letting her go for good because she wants to focus on school, which she's been doing that. she was focusing on school, trying to graduate. She told you that in 12th grade. Now she's telling you this again in college. Like, what the? How many more times does she need to tell you that she want to focus on school?
Oh, about time.
I love me some Quando. I think Quando's cool. Great dang rapper, great guy. Funny on Twitter. But time to let it go, baby. Let it go. You really, like, kept this girl hostage. You know what's so funny to me? Imagine waiting for her to get out of high school. And then you got to wait 4 more years. Bitch, you got me fucked. Well, good luck. It ain't about me. Let's keep it. Okay. Next for the Sugar Honey Iced Tea, we got Charles White. He was doing
this
a
nigga
show.
Here.
And I guess in the show, I don't know if he done said something to the guy, but whatever he said, done upset the guy. Upset the guy. And this is what happened.
He mask out. Talk right.
I already got the back here. Okay,
talk right.
I don't give a damn about getting booed. I already got the back here. I don't give a damn about getting booed, nigga. I done already got paid. You paid to see me, nigga. You paid to see me. Lakers, Jazz, and Worm ass, nigga. Pull out some money, though. Pull out some money, though. Pull out some money, though, nigga.
I ain't gonna lie. Nigga can't. Why you go to his show if you was, you know, if you ain't like him?
Bitch ass, nigga. Pull out some money.
That was a waste of time.
I'll hit you in your goddamn head, nigga. Pull out some money, nigga. I'll hit you in your goddamn head.
All right, y'all, so I'm going to have to cut this part because for some reason YouTube love to mess up my Messy Monday videos because of a fight or something, so.
Why you was hitting him with stuff and then running? I don't know. So then Charleston went on live and this is what he said.
Soon he get enough. Oh, dude, I hit him with a knife. I hit that nigga with a
knife. Dewberry went to knocking them bitch-ass niggas out.
I hit that hoe.
I got whooped. I fought 7 niggas and they ain't got a scratch on me.
And that nigga laid down.
And all them niggas, ew, them all them niggas trying to
I ain't got a scratch on me. Ain't nothing swollen on me. And I'm sitting here counting them niggas money.
Y'all, everybody algorithm is the same. Everybody channel, I mean, what? Everybody algorithm is different and everybody's channel is different. Okay, so just because it don't happen to Zoe don't mean it won't happen to me. You know what I'm saying?
I have a scratch.
I just know what it does for my channel. That's all I can speak on.
But I know damn well you sore. Like, ain't no damn way. But we gonna follow the same thing. You did throw that plant first. So you got what you asked for. So he was on live with that little white boy. And I could have sworn he didn't like the white boy. He said the white boy had set him up with some gay shit with, you know what.
What you doing?
Shit, nothing. Just got football tackled by a nigga on stage.
Oh, my God.
Football tackled? How did that happen?
He used his shoulder. His uncle, him and his uncle was sitting together, in a compromised position. His uncle had his arm around him like he was a girl, and they were the only two people in the crowd with basketball jerseys on. Everybody else had on cowboy boots, cowboy hats. And them niggas had on basketball jerseys, and they was heckling me. And so I accused them niggas of being a nephew and an uncle who fuck each other.
Damn!
It's Austin.
Oh, he tried them first.
Let me ask you something. You threw everything on the stage. But your fist. If it ain't about me, let's get in, okay? All right, you guys, that's all I have for the sugar honey iced tea. Let's get into this mess. First, okay, we have...
Damn, y'all, the sugar honey iced tea with 30 minutes.
Damn. Now, baby, this is just a whole lot, a whole lot, a whole lot, a whole lot, a whole lot. And it started with the casting situation when she filed the lawsuit against him, and he paid within a day.
Her attorneys were really brilliant. They didn't sue just Diddy. They sued his corporation.
They sure did.
And they sued his corporations and sued as in her capacity as an employee. When you do that, it triggers commercial liability insurance.
Yeah.
And it triggers another policy called directors and officers. Okay? And we know he's a director.
Correct.
Of these companies. Uh-huh. As the CEO. So now you got two policies. What happens then is it takes away Puffy's ability to settle. It's not his choice no more.
So it's no longer personal accountability. It's his organization.
It's his organization. And it's no different than, like, if you hit somebody with your car.
Mm-hmm.
Let's say you have State Farm. Mm-hmm. State Farm gets to decide to settle, not you. You could say, I didn't run the stop sign. That's not true. They're lying. If mm-hmm. State Farm says, we don't care. We did our investigation. We're settling. That's it. That's what happened here. So because they added those claims, the corporate insurance carrier got to say, read over and say, oh, hell no, we giving her the money.
We're hearing you. Diddy's public reputation is done.
It's done.
Absolutely. Yeah.
And if he wants to be able to leave anything to his children, he needs to walk away from all of these corporations.
Damn, he can no longer be the head of his corporations.
Well, remember, didn't I say directors and officers liability?
Yeah.
More than likely, what will happen is those insurance companies, they have the ability to say, we won't renew your policy if he continues to be a director or officer.
And then that's when some more women came out. But then when these businesses started pulling away from him, I think, like, what did these businesses
he
know?
He 18 brand deals.
That made
damn,
them want to
18?
Pull away. Now, 18? Was it 18 or 8? I think it's 18 businesses have pulled away from Diddy.
No, 18 brand deals is crazy. That's worth, like, can you imagine losing one? 18?
And it's like, well, what? Hold on. What's going on? Are they saving face? Or do they know the real tea? So then, child, folks just coming out. They saying stuff. Some celebrities are talking. Mm-hmm. 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 Mm-hmm.
She actually didn't say anything at that moment. She's so crazy.
So Diddy came out And he has now said this.
Always the list. Please, please, God told me to ask y'all for help. I need.
See, this is going to give me a copyright.
I need your help. I need your help. I
bottles right there. They've been to have something to make the girl.
This is going to give me a copyright. And y'all, for some reason, I get copyrights with these things. Every time I react to a messy Monday, I get a copyright. And I don't know if Zoe get them, but I get them for sure.
And Bay, she has to now pay him $125,000 in damages with this lawsuit that she tried to file on him, allegedly saying that, you know, he did some things to her child. And it was very disturbing, but come to find out, it didn't happen. Now, for those who don't remember, she was dragging this man. I mean, almost ruined his whole career. Like, the stuff she was saying was sick.
It is annoying for him.
They finally went to court. It was a trial. They had a jury and everything. And he was now found not guilty, and she has to pay this in damages. And it's just crazy how people are still in the comments saying, oh, I still believe her. I still believe her. And they
Yeah, that man didn't do that. I didn't feel like he did it anyway. She was thugging him real bad with that.
Had a jury and a trial and evidence and stuff. Fuck it. She paying. If it ain't about me, let's keep eating. Okay. Next on the docket, we have Tamar and Tommie Lee. Now, baby, I don't know where this gonna go, but it looks like it's going somewhere.
That's why I had to go get my man back, y'all. Y'all thought I was gonna let my man go because he took some crackhead to a basketball game.
Oh my God, a crackhead is crazy.
No, man, that was not my man. He don't owe me no loyalty when we broke up. I could have went out with his homeboy. What's up? It's all fair game when you broke up. Don't get it fucked up.
Let's get into it. So all I said was,
girl, I don't need all to see I your said body. Was
drive a Rolls Royce.
That, I really hate seeing their bodies.
And he was down to play op games. I wouldn't take nothing like that serious, my love. That too. And from there, he had a nice suit. And from there, he was thirsty. He wanted to fly me out. What's wrong with me going to a game? What is wrong with the situation is that is your man, as you call it. That is your man. He knew it was a situation with me and you. And he was down. He was down to play op games. I wouldn't take nothing like that serious, my love. That ate my ass, and I sent him on his way.
Damn.
It wasn't the, I don't know, middle class house that he lives in Atlanta. It wasn't the Bentleys, because I drive a Rolls Royce, that got me. It wasn't... I don't know, the slick part thing he got going on. It wasn't none of that.
Damn! Your middle class house in Atlanta is crazy. But not only that, not his little Bentleys, because she drives the Rolls Royce. Damn.
It was when he paid for the Waldorf in points. I knew that I could no longer.
The Waldorf. Now she's seen his house, but he took it to a hotel.
Play this game.
In points.
One thing, JR, you never want to play with me. You don't want me to expose how you were saying that you kicked her out and she went back to her mother's house. Not Mrs. Braxton. Not Mrs. Singer with the sold out tour that JR also told me was flex. It was cap. It was she flexing. She don't have no sold
out. Between me and
you
too.
Was the exact words. The tour not sold out. He said you was messy. He said you went back to your mother's house. He told me a lot of things that he shouldn't tell a stranger. I just met this man less than a week. Love, if that's your man, as you say, then you need to check him. You need to really check him and check your situation and really see if you're sleeping with the enemy or not.
Damn.
I'm not your problem. I don't know you.
So I don't know, Tamar. Just Damn. Looking from the outside in, I don't think this was the right choice, sis. Because when somebody show you who they are, believe them.
Hello.
This man did you bad. Now I feel like he knows, okay, I got away with it one time. Oh, now I can do her the worst way. So I'm just saying, I don't know. Something ain't sitting right with me. This man, it ain't sitting right. And then after this woman done said it, this man done ate her pussy too. Girl,
He's just, she said
that man playing your face is one thing. But fussing over a man that like he owns slaves. Here's another. All right. Well, if it ain't about me, let's get in it. Hey! Next one, Doc, we have Blueface.
He does very much give me Leonardo DiCaprio. And Django.
Now, I'm not finna go on and on and on about this because they will fuss for 3 days straight and it'd be too much shit to talk about.
So, what
we gonna get straight down to the dirty is Blueface had pushed up to Krishan's house. Her friend Marsh was there, baby.
Okay, we gonna make this a separate video.
But fussing over a man that like he owns slaves. Here's another. All right, what?
All right, so we're going to make this a separate video. Y'all let me know what y'all thinking down in the comment section below. Do y'all think Tamar is crazy for going back to that man? Because I do. I mean, after I seen him out with her, he would have been cut off. Facts. So, yeah, y'all let me know what y'all think about that down in the comment section below. Love y'all. Appreciate y'all. Hell yeah.